Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 2390, solving Slugify with recursive lambdas. Yep, I'm going to try and explain these recursive lambdas in plain English. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Today, an example from my friend Smozgur at the Mr. Excel Message Board. There's a problem in web development where you have to take an article title and convert it to HTML. And that process is called Slugify. So they take an article title, convert to lowercase, keep anything that's A through Z or 0 through 9, and everything else becomes a dash. But then at the end, if you have dash, dash, you have to change it to a single dash. And today I'm going to show you how we can solve this using something called a recursive lambda. That's where one of these new lambda functions in Excel calls itself, right? Which is crazy. It's essentially doing a loop like you would do in VBA. And I'm going to show you step by step in plain English how that works. And before I do that, I just want to note that this could have been done in Excel without lambdas, but it was super ugly. Here's one where I take a phrase and character by character, splitting it out using the mid function, check to see what the character code is. Is that character code between 97 and 122 or 48 and 57? That's A through Z, 0 through 9. Get everything before that character, get that character or a dash. Get everything to the right of that character, put it back together, and then increment the index by one, and are we done? Are we more than the length of G3? And if we're not, then go back around. Down here, 64, 65 rows of formulas, I finally get the end result. It's ridiculous to do it this way. The other way is to say, all right, there's 36 characters we want to keep. Let's do substitute 219 times. Here's all the different substitutes, getting rid of all the bad characters, and then finally at the end, one more substitute where we do a trim of the substitute of every dash to a space. That gets rid of the multiple dashes and then change it back to a dash. Still not a fun way to go, right? And we can solve this whole thing, any title over here in column A, using the Slugify function that Smozgur wrote and posted in the great section of the Mr. Excel message board where people are posting their cool lambdas. I'll put a link down below. All right, I'm just gonna walk through this bit by bit because when you encounter this formula, it seems just overwhelming. But when you go through it one piece at a time, it's really not that complicated. And you can use this as a model to create your own loops. All right, so what we're going to do is we're gonna pass to the Slugify function, the phrase that we want to see, and the number one. Why the number one? That's saying that we're going to do a loop for I equals one to the length of the phrase. All right, so we're always starting at one. It'd be nice if in Lambda we could put the one there, but you know, simple enough. For right now, until they give us some more Lambda tools, we're going to pass the one. So we call Slugify by passing a phrase and an index of one. And then first line of the Slugify is essentially at the end of my formulas. It's saying, is the index, is that number one greater than the length of the phrase? And if it is, then we're gonna come down here and bail out. But otherwise, we're gonna enter the loop. So this whole box here is the, we're not done yet. We haven't processed all of the letters in the phrase. And when that's true, we're going to call Slugify again. And with this call of Slugify, we're going to pass it a different phrase. We'll talk about these six lines that calculate the phrase for the next call to Slugify. And this time, the index is going to be one more than it was before. So the first time we call it Slugify, it's looking at character one. When we're done looking at character one, we're going to pass it a two. So the index plus one. All right, now here's kind of what's happening inside that let function. This is where it's calculating the phrase that it's going to send to Slugify the second time, the third time, the fourth time. We get the character code using the code function, get everything to the left of the character and everything to the right of the character. And then the heart of the Slugify, the thing that actually makes it work, is this line right here. We say, is the character a lowercase letter, in other words, between 97 and 122 inclusive, or is it a digit, 48 to 57 inclusive? If it is, then just put the character in the phrase. Otherwise, replace it with a dash. All right, so there you have it. A lambda function that actually calls itself, looping through each character in any argument that we would pass it. Now, in order to actually make this work, we copy all of these characters from the lambda function and go into formulas define name. I've already done that. So here in name manager, I created a name called Slugify, pasted the whole thing in there, click close, and then we just have anything. And equals Slugify of that phrase, comma, one. And it'll get rid of all the illegal characters. Well, hey, this example is from my new book, Mr. Excel 2021, Unmasking Excel. Click that I in the top right-hand corner for more information about the book. If you like this video, please like, subscribe, and ring the bell. Feel free to post any questions or comments down in the YouTube comments below. I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast, Mr. Excel.